Hello friends, today we will be solving the coin change problem. This is the famous problem. In order to learn the dynamic programming, the basics of dynamic programming, you can consider, like, in this you are given coins of different denomination and total amount of money amount. Write a functions to compute the fewest number of coins that you need to make up to that amount. If that amount of money cannot be made up by any combination of the coins, return minus one. So it is like, suppose you are given this coins 1, 2, 5 and total amount is 11. How many are the number, minimum number of coins which are required to get this amount? So we can consider, like, we can have 2 5 rupees coins and 1 1 rupees coins, and then this will be 3. This is the minimum. In second example, you can see, like, the coins, there are coins of 2 only and the amount is 3, so we cannot make amount 3 with coins of 2, so we are returning minus 1. So today how we are doing it is, like, initially we can thought of as a recursive solution. So if we do this by recursive solution, then there will be a TLE. Okay, so what we can do is, like, we can have a result array which will be storing the results, different results which will come in recursion. So for example, we came to know that, like, for 10 rupees, these are the minimum number of coins, so we will save that 10, so that in the next iteration, if it comes to 10, then we will have that result and we can give it back. So we can do like that also. So what's, as of now, what we are doing is, like, we have written one coin change function over here. So in this, there is a coins array, the remaining amount and the resultant array, which will be storing the results of different number of coins. Like, for the, suppose you are competing for 10 rupees, so recursively it will compute for 5 also in some point of time, or in for different number of rupees it will compute the minimum number of in the some point of time in the recursive manner. So at that time we will be storing that result in this array. So in this recursive function, if remaining is 0, remaining amount is 0, we are just returning 0. If remaining is less than 0, then we cannot return, so we are returning minus 1. So if our resultant array contains that remaining element, then we are returning that value. Now we are initializing minimum as an integer dot max value, and now we are iterating all the elements of coins. So in the count section, we have declared a integer count which will be calling to coin change with the coins array and the remaining minus I, means this will be reduced by remaining minus I. Suppose 1 to 5 is there, so initially coin number 1 amount is 11, so 11 minus 1, and it will call like coins array will be sent, and 11 minus 1 is 10, 10 will be sent, and the resultant array will be sent, and again this will loop over here, it will come back over here, it will iterate like for 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 recursively for the all the number of coins. So you can consider, like, for 1 1 1 1 1 1 every element of 1 it will go first, then after 1 it will go for 2 3 4 5 6 7 in the whatever amount of coins are in the recursive way. Okay, when remaining becomes 0, it will return 0. If remaining is less than 0, then it will return minus 1. So over here we are calling to this method, and if count is greater than or equal to 0, means if it is returning, if this path is returning solution and count is less than minimum, which we define over here, which is the max value, then we are setting that minimum to the count plus 1. Plus 1 is because we are calling coin change function, and in this function we are just passing remaining minus I, means we have used I once, so we are just incrementing that count over here. So we will be setting minimum equal to count plus 1. In those, after this steps, it will come over here and we will be storing resultant of remaining minus 1 equal to, if minimum value is not set, it means that the solution is minus 1, else it will be returning the minimum amount, and then we will be returning resultant of remaining minus 1. So this is the problem solution. Let's see whether it gets executed or not. Yes, it got executed. It's not that fast, but if you do it recursively, then it will be having time limit issues. So it will not, only 15 test cases will pass. So if you apply DP, then it will be like it will come in acceptable manner. The other thing we can do is like we can solve this by iterative way. So this thing I will be doing in next videos. Thank you.